I'm going to show you how to make select Canon DSLR, mirrorless and PowerShot cameras into high quality webcams without needing any extra hardware, and it's completely free. Hi, I'm Tosh Lubeck from DIYvideostudio.com, and the great news is that you can stream video from any one of 25 Canon cameras to a PC with nothing more than a USB cable and the new Canon webcam software. I'll tell you where you can download the software and how to install it, so keep watching until the end of this video. But first, if you find this video useful, please like it by hitting the thumbs up button, because it really does help me here on YouTube. And if you'd like to be the first to be notified when I publish similar videos about how you can make your own videos and YouTube content, hit the subscribe button and remember to click the notifications bell. In my last video, I talked about charging the EOS R's battery inside the camera using the USB-C port. If you're interested in seeing that video, I'll put a link in the card over there. But Canon has enabled new functionality through the USB-C port. At least it has on 25 of its DSLR, mirrorless and PowerShot cameras. Here's a list of those cameras. If any more are added, I'll have an updated list of compatible cameras on my website. The link will be in the description below. But you can see the list includes cameras that are popular amongst YouTubers, like the Canon 77D, the 80D, 90D, the M50, the R and RP. Right now, during the lockdown, big brand webcams are like gold dust. They were sold out early on, and so are many video capture devices like this Elgato CanLink 4K. During this period, home workers have been relying on video calls to stay connected, so not being able to get hold of a good quality webcam has forced many to either use a smartphone or their laptop's internal webcam, which, generally speaking, isn't very good. But now, you can connect many Canon cameras to a 64-bit Windows 10 computer and use it as a super quality webcam. You can get DSLR video quality and even blurry backgrounds when you do video meetings or live streams. All you need is a compatible Canon camera, the USB cable, and Canon's free EOS Webcam Utility Beta software. I'll put a link to the software down in the description. Use the link to head over to the Canon EOS Webcam Utility Beta webpage. Scroll down and you'll see the 25 compatible cameras listed. Each one is a link to the support page for that specific camera. Find and click the link for your camera, and once you're on the product support page, click on the Drivers and Downloads tab, or if you prefer, just scroll down. If the Software tab isn't already selected, click on it. In the Operating Systems drop-down list, if it's not already detected, choose Windows 10 x64. Now find EOS Webcam Utility Beta for Windows. On the right side of the screen, click the Select button, and when the red Download button is revealed, click on it to start the download. When the download is complete, locate the software in your Downloads folder and run the installer. Now, once the software is installed, you'll need to reboot your computer before you can use your Canon camera as a webcam. After the reboot, your camera should be recognized as a video source by many video conferencing, streaming, and recording applications. The next bit is simple. It's setting up your camera to work with your PC. Now, turn on your camera and change it to the movie or video shooting mode you want. On my EOS R that I'm using, I'd press the Mode button and then the Info button to change from photo to video mode. Then I'll choose the setting I want. Normally that's TV or Shutter Priority AE, but mostly M, that's manual exposure. Then make sure that you turn on autofocus. I normally use face and eye detect. You next want to adjust the exposure settings to get everything looking the way that you want. You can now move on to linking your camera and PC. So uncover the USB socket on the side of your camera and connect the USB cable. Plug the other end of the USB cable into a USB port on your PC. I'm using a USB 3.0 port since that'll give me a fast connection. Although on this laptop, I also have a USB 3.1 Type-C port that is theoretically twice the speed, so that would also work well. Once the camera and PC are connected, Windows may ask what you want to do next. Don't worry about that, just ignore it and the notification will disappear. But on the camera screen, or at least on my EOS on screen, a picture of a computer monitor appears, indicating the camera and PC are connected. That screen will change once the camera has been selected as the video source in the settings of your application that you're using. So how do you get your camera now to appear in your app? Well, open your meeting, streaming or recording app and in the video settings, choose EOS Webcam Utility Beta as your video source. The camera screen will become active again and the video feed will appear in your app's video display. Notice the difference between the screen on the camera and the video display on your meeting app. The camera is sending a clean signal. That means you don't see all your camera settings overlaid on the image. I've installed the webcam software on both my desktop PC and my laptop, and I've used my EOS R camera with Zoom, the meeting software, and Open Broadcaster Software, or OBS, the streaming application. But so far, I've not been able to get Skype to show EOS Webcam Utility Beta as a video source on my laptop. Because the software is a beta version, you should be aware that it might contain bugs or it might not behave as you might expect. Also, Canon states that the software is intended for use in the US only. If you're based outside of the US and decide to download and install the software, it will work, but Canon will not offer support outside of the US. I hope you enjoyed and found this video useful. If you have, please hit the thumbs up button. For more videos that will help you create your own YouTube content, hit the subscribe button and remember to hit the notifications bell. You'll be the first to hear when I publish new videos. You can also find articles and gear reviews for video creators on my website. That's DIYVideoStudio.com. Until next time, thanks for watching.